attachments. Capsule of shoulder joint is attached on the anatomical neck, but medially it is lower by 2 to 2.5 centimeters. Lesser tubercle. The multipennate subscapularis arising from subscapular fossa is inserted into the lesser tubercle. It forms anterior relation of shoulder joint. Greater tubercle, it has three distinct areas. Upper one is for supraspinatus from supraspinous fossa of scapula. Middle one is for infraspinatus, and lowest is for attachment of teres minor from lateral border of scapula. Four muscles keep large head of humerus in position during the movements of shoulder joint. Intertubercular sulcus. Lateral lip gives insertion to the pectoralis major muscle. This is a bilaminar insertion. Medial lip gives attachment to teres major, and floor is the attachment of big latissimus dorsi. The mnemonic is lady between two majors. Deltoid tuberosity provides insertion of deltoid muscle. The intermuscular tendons of acromial fibers of muscle are attached here. Medial border in its middle gives attachment to coracobrachialis, representing the medial compartment of upper arm. Anterior surface in most of its part gives attachment to chief flexor and prime mover of elbow joint, the brachialis muscle. Posterior surface in upper part gives attachment to lateral head of triceps brachii. Most of the posterior surface gives attachment to large medial head of triceps brachii. In between these two heads is the oblique radial sulcus, containing important radial nerve and profunda brachii vessels. The third long head is from infraglenoid tubercle of scapula. Triceps brachii is the chief extensor of elbow joint. Medial epicondyle gives attachment Lateral epicondyle gives attachment to common extensor origin for superficial extensors of wrist joint. Upper two-third of lateral supracondylar ridge gives attachment to brachioradialis for partially pronating and partially supinating the forearm. Lower one-third of lateral supracondylar ridge gives attachment to extensor carpi radialis longus muscle. Lower one-third of lateral supracondylar ridge gives attachment to extensor carpi radialis longus muscle. Medial epicondyle gives attachment to common flexor origin for the superficial flexors of the wrist joint. Into the radial fossa fits the margin of head of radius during flexion of elbow joint. Show it on the skeleton. Skeleton mein dikha raha hu. Into the coronoid fossa fits the edge of coronoid process of ulna during flexion of elbow. Into the olecranon fossa fits the olecranon process of ulna during extension of elbow joint. the axillary nerve and posterior circumflex humeral vessels are related at the surgical neck of humerus. Dikhao piche bana hua. Radial nerve and profunda brachii vessels are lying in the radial sulcus. Ulnar nerve with the superior ulnar collateral vessels lie behind the medial epicondyle. Pressure on the ulnar nerve causes tingling sensation in the forearm. One feels like laughing. That is why medial epicondyle is called the funny bone and the whole bone is called humerus. Of supraspinatus from suprascapular fossa to the upper impression on the greater tubercle of humerus. The infraspinatus arises from the lower infraspinous fossa, gets inserted into middle impression on the greater tubercle of humerus. The teres minor, arising from the lateral border with a gap, gets inserted into the lowest impression on the greater tubercle. The subscapularis muscle, arising from the costal aspect of scapula, passes anterior to the shoulder joint and gets inserted into the lesser tubercle of the humerus. Four muscles, the supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor and subscapularis, get fused with the capsule of the shoulder joint and form the musculotendinous cuff of the shoulder. It is also known as the rotator cuff. Figure shows the origin of brachialis muscle from the anterolateral and anteromedial surfaces of the humerus. It passes in front of the elbow joint and gets inserted into the anterior aspect of the coronoid process of the ulna.